Hi, I'm Sam Mard from the Solidworks training team, and today we're diving into race car design by modeling and racing cars powered entirely by balloons. With Solidworks X Design, we'll use CAD to explore how design choices affect performance and bring our ideas to life with 3D printing and prototyping. Since the first cars hit the road in the late 1800s, engineers have been pushing the limits of vehicle design, making each generation a little bit better than the last. By the early 20th century, driving had evolved into high-speed competition, giving rise to Grand Prix racing. Legendary models like the Alfa Romeo 158, Cooper T43, and Lotus 49 led the way. These cars featured sleek, open cockpits, exposed wheels, and great maneuverability at high speeds, all trademarks of early race car engineering. The balloon racer that we'll be designing today draws on that same spirit of innovation, inspired by the sleek styling and function of these classic race cars. Now, we're not using engines here, but the principles are the same. Specifically, Newton's third law says that for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. But instead of engine combustion, our action is air rushing out of the balloon, which travels through the balloon mount and out the back like a mini turbojet. And the reaction? Our racer launching forward, of course. In this project, we'll walk through the full design and engineering process, including how we define design intent based on how the car should function, modeling our key components using CAD tools, virtually assembling the racer in X-Design, exporting parts and prepping them for 3D printing, testing and refining based on performance, and then finally, racing and reviewing our final designs. First up, we have design intent. Here, our goal is to design a balloon-powered racer that not only travels far and fast, but looks sleek while doing it. In engineering design, this is called design intent, making sure every part of the design serves a purpose, both functionally and structurally. And the core challenge is this: how do we turn the energy of an inflated balloon into a smooth, controlled forward motion? A few key things need to go right. First, as the balloon deflates, the car should travel in a straight, stable line. Second, the wheels must spin freely, so axle spacing and hub tolerances matter. But that's not enough. The wheels also need to stay on during high-speed launches, so we'll need secure axle caps. And finally, the car must stay balanced. If the body is too small or the balloon sits too high, the racer might not do what we want it to do. So how do we solve all of this in our design? Let's start with the main body. While I recommend beginning with simpler components, I'm starting here because everything else, from the wheels to the axle caps and even the spoiler, depend on the dimensions of the body. So, it is about 100 millimeters long and acts as the structural frame that connects all the parts together. There's a circular cutout through the midplane that even resembles the cockpit of the race cars that we looked at earlier. One key feature is the balloon channel. It is a swept cut that curves from the top, through the body, and exits at the rear. I like to call this the exhaust. This creates a clean airflow path for smooth balloon deflation and straight propulsion. And if we look around the back, there's a shallow cutout that provides a simple mount for the spoiler. Also, to keep things simple and minimize the printed pieces, the axles are built directly into the sides as 5mm diameter extrusions. Once the body is complete, we move on to the wheels. Their job is to rotate smoothly while holding the body off the ground. The axle hole is sized just slightly larger than the axle itself, which gives enough clearance for smooth rotation without too much looseness. The wheel's structural and visual details come from a single spoke cutout, which we then pattern around the center using the circular pattern tool. This ensures rotational symmetry for balance at high speeds. Next up, the axle caps. These small but essential parts snap onto the axle ends and keep the wheels secure. Their wall thickness depends on your 3D printer's tolerance, and on mine, a shell wall thickness of about 0.9 millimeters gave me a snug fit around the axles. And for our last part, we'll model the spoiler. It's part function and part flare. Besides looking cool, it helps stabilize the balloon from falling backwards. Its main profiles are extruded from a sketch on a midplane, And like the axle caps, its connector dimensions will also depend on your printer's tolerance. For my setup, a gap between 0.2 and 0.3 millimeters worked pretty well. Now, before printing, it's helpful to virtually assemble your car in X-Design and make sure all the parts fit together the way you intended. In the Assembly tab, we can use the Mate tool to add features like coincident mates between flat faces and concentric mates between cylindrical features like the axles and the wheels. This lets you catch any last-minute issues before fabrication. Also, the wheels, axle caps, and spoiler are all designed to be easily swappable. This means you can test different wheel sizes or spoiler shapes without redesigning the whole car. That's not just useful, but it's a core part of engineering iteration. Take advantage of this modularity and be creative with your design, as subtle changes in any component can make all the difference. Once you've finished modeling, use the 3D print tool in X-Design to export each component as an STL file. Then, bring them into your slicing software and orient each part so that its largest flat face sits against the build plate. This improves stability and reduces the need for supports. To speed up the print time, you can nest multiple components together to print in batches. You can even print multiple versions of a part with slight design tweaks. I find this is a great way to test tolerances and find what fits or functions the best. And once you're ready, start your print and watch as your racer comes to life layer by layer. Remember that video I showed you earlier? The one where the racer popped a wheelie and dragged its balloon across the ground? Let's talk about why that happened. After breaking down this first prototype, I found a few key issues. The car was far too small and light compared to the balloon, so it lifted off the ground. Also, the exhaust was too wide, which let all of the air out way too fast instead of giving a steady push. To fix this, I built and tested a bunch of other prototypes. This larger model, while doing a better job at staying grounded, used a little too much material and took too long to print for my liking. I wanted to come up with a design that was a little more sustainable in its material use and that would be available for everyone to print much faster. So then I moved on to this smaller body where I put the mount in the middle of the vehicle. While this improved the front to back balance of the car, the balloon had no side to side balance, so it would often cause the car to wobble and swerve around like crazy. These are perfect examples of engineering trade-offs, where solving one problem can often introduce another. In the end, I landed on this mid-sized model with a lower balloon mount and smaller exhaust opening. It's a solid balance between stability, efficiency, and reliability. So, don't be afraid to fail, tweak your design, and try again, because every new version brings you one step closer to your best design. And now that we're done modeling in X-Design, checking our assembly, and prototyping, it's time for the fun part, to race the cars. So, grab some friends, line up your cars, and put your builds to the test. Which racer is fastest off the line? Which one's the most stable? And of course, which one looks the coolest? Keep experimenting and modifying to see how different designs perform under pressure, as this is where engineering meets creativity, and where both meet fun. Thanks for following along, and be sure to check out the links below for step-by-step tutorials and other fun SolidWorks design challenges. See you next time, and happy racing!